So I teach an elective here at INSEAD called Org 2.0, Organization 2.0. And the key premise of that course is we want to teach our students the tools by which they will design organizations rather than teach them a particular design. And the way we do it is we really expose them to the most cutting edge ideas in analytics. So we teach them machine learning, network analysis, experiment design, computational agent-based modeling. And the sum of this is really to say, we don't want to take a bet to tell you that the organization design of the future will be flat or will be vertical or will be horizontal. We don't know. Maybe this is true, maybe it's not. What we want to do is give you the tools to look at the data in your own organizational context and design the structure that's best for you. So in some sense, I think the big new frontier here is not so much a forecast about which design will dominate, but a platform of tools that will allow people to design their own organizations.
And what are the key pillars to consider when it comes to organization design?
My philosophy when teaching organization design, or even when consulting with companies on this, is I don't have a design that I would like to preach to companies. I don't think we know of any such one universal design. That's one of the most important things we've learned. What we have learned is a set of tools which can be used to redesign our own organizations and a set of principles. Now, the principles. The first big idea here is let's not restrict our thinking about design to structure. Let's make sure we're considering how structure interacts with sorting, whom you are hiring, and with the sense-making process, how people shape their own understanding of their organizational context. Which means that a structure that works very well in one context where you hired a particular kind of workforce may not work at all in a different one where the workforce is completely different. So there are no universally translatable structures. There are structural principles, microstructures being an example. So that's one set of ideas which are, I think, universal. The designs are not universal, but the idea that one should look at every design from the perspective of structure, sorting, and sense making, that's universal. The second universal idea is that the tools we have for redesigning organizations have expanded a lot in the last decade or so, and mainly because of the power of algorithms. In particular, in the Org 2.0 class that I teach at INSEAD, we cover three kinds of approaches to redesign. The first is called perception. The idea is we use data that's already available in the organization to understand how the organization is currently functioning. So simple descriptive statistics can sometimes be very powerful. Beyond perception, we talk about prediction. So we use machine learning to mine past data to make predictions about what might change, what might happen in terms of, for instance, who might quit, who might be a successful employee, which teams are more likely to accomplish their objectives. These are all things that using past data, we can make predictions about. But beyond perception and prediction, the ultimate gold standard is prototyping, by which I mean, rather than try out an organizational design change at large scale, roll it out, spending millions of dollars, and then hoping for the best, we could actually prototype this in the same way that an airline company would prototype a new aircraft in a wind tunnel. So the way we would do this is a combination of two ideas. First, we might run simple experiments in which, with randomization and treatment and control groups, we try out the organizational change we want to implement, but do it at a relatively small scale in a way that is not going to affect the rest of the organization, but allows us to learn if this will actually work. Now, this is with real people, with real work, and in real time. But an alternative way to experiment is actually in silico, by which I mean building computational models of how organizations work. So these are agent-based models, a lot like the kind of models that traffic designers use when trying to forecast the flow of traffic around the island of Singapore. So rather than run experiments in real time, if we build reasonably good models, we can run the experiments in the computer. So we can actually make changes and see what is likely to happen in the system. So given that, for instance, we know people form network ties with people they are physically proximate to. We know this to be a fact. Suppose we were to change the seating arrangement in an organization. What would that do to the structure of networks? So rather than run that experiment in real time, which might be expensive, we might build a computational model and tweak it and see exactly what's likely to happen. So perception, prediction, prototyping, these are the toolkit. And structuring, sorting, and sense making. These are the three pillars of design. I think these are universal. Beyond that, as I said, every company will be different.
Okay, Phanish, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.